Good morning, Year 5, and welcome to this week's assembly. It's my first go. I've been looking forward to this. I know how much learning you've been sending in. I've been absolutely bowled over by the amount of stuff you've been sending in, far more than the Year 6s have. It's been very difficult, I imagine, for your teachers to choose stars and learners, but that's their problem, and I'm sure Miss Gwinnett has made short work of it. Over to her.
Thank you, Mr. Fern. And hi, Year 5. It's lovely to see all of your incredible learning coming through to the Year 5 parents' email address. I've been really enjoying seeing which challenges you're having a go at and what's keeping you busy at home at this time. But your learner of the week this week, Reg One, is somebody who has not only accessed the challenges that we have been setting for you, but they've branched out to find some activities from different year groups too. They've had a go at the Year 6 quiz, they've had a go at the daily maths problems set in Year 4. Not only that, but they've been doing some incredible baking at home too. So your learner of the week this week goes to Lewis. You're doing an incredible job, Lewis. Please keep it up. You are fantastic. Your star of the week this week, Reg One, is earning their badge for independence. And that is because this person just does not stop. After they finish their home learning, they're then setting themselves their own challenges, be that something creative, where they're drawing a picture or taking on a new craft project, to getting out in the garden, riding their bike, feeding the birds, even making a den in the back garden. I've even seen the s'mores that this person has made on a fire in their back garden too. They looked delicious. So this week, your star is Lucy. Congratulations, Lucy. You are showing such independence in your learning and showing how you know where you want your learning to take you next. And that is such a skill to have, and it's so fantastic to see. Keep up the fantastic work. You are a superstar.
Congratulations on your independent star.
Over to Mrs. Patel in Reg 2 to find out who her star and learner are this week.
Thank you, Miss Gwinnett, and hello to everyone in Reg 2. It's a new week, so we have a new learner and star for the week. Here goes. So our learner is somebody who I feel has been working a little bit quietly and behind the scenes since we haven't been at school. Don't get me wrong, he has been taking part in the TT Rockstar Battles, which has been fantastic, but it was lovely to see all the work that he has been completing since we haven't been at school. And when I say all the work, I mean all the work. I had so many emails of his learning from his mum last week, and it was fantastic to see. He had completed all the English, the maths, the humanities, and I'm so impressed with the fact that he's been working so diligently at home as he does in the classroom. So well done to Alfie. Well done, Alfie. Okay, moving on to our star. So our star this week is somebody who's been showing a lot of the Eastport values at home, and his mum can vouch for this as well. He has been persevering, he's been resilient, he's been creative, he's been honest, he's been respectful, all of them. And obviously I can't give him all of the stars, so I've settled for self-belief because I feel like this kind of encapsulates the rest of the values that he's been showing too quite nicely. So with some support, this individual has shown that he can achieve whatever he puts his mind to. He knows he needs to be honest with himself when he's struggling a little bit, or he might have to persevere a little bit more to actually achieve what he wants to do. But with the support from that adult, and after having a little bit of a pep talk, his confidence levels are sky high again, and he knows that he can achieve it. So well done, and keep it up too. Our star this week is Chad. Well done, Chad. I've been really impressed with all the self-belief that you've been showing with all of your learning at home. Great job.
Congratulations on your self-belief star.
Okay, I'm going to hand over to Mrs. Hazel now so we can hear about the stars and learners in their class.
Hi, Year 5. It's that exciting time of week again where I have the opportunity to share with you the star and learner for Year 5 Reg 3. And I must say, this week it has been very tricky choosing you because the amount of work you're sending in is fantastic. What's more, the quality of it as well is phenomenal, so well done. I have, however, managed to choose the star and learner. So are we ready? First up, learner. This is being awarded to a young lady who has been completing lots of learning at home, and she's blown me away with her math challenges. That young lady is Janisha. I really enjoyed reading your work, Janisha, and you did some investigative work on separating mixtures for science, and I enjoyed reading your reasoning through for that. And it's really lovely to see that you're dipping into some of the work set by other year groups as well, which is fantastic. Well done. Now to STAR. This week, we would like to award the STAR for respect to Georgia. Like Janisha, Georgia's been completing lots of home learning. She's sent in examples of science work, English work, maths work, and has been playing on Timetable Rockstars a lot too, which is fantastic. However, she wrote one paragraph about kindness, which really stood out and has pipped everybody else in the post for the reason why she is STAR of the week. And I hope she doesn't mind, but I'd like to read it to you. Kindness is a powerful word. There is lots of acts of kindness being provided at this disturbing time. It's nice to see most of my street are clapping for the NHS. They are our heroes of 2020. But why did the virus have to show how important and amazing they are? We need them more than ever. They have showed us their bravery and self-belief. They are really our angels who live on this earth. No more, no less. My best friend's mum is one of our angels. I have heaps of respect for her. I tried keeping her spirits up when her mum is working hard. They are the glue which keeps our earth together. From reading that paragraph, it is just filled with so many of our East Park 8 values, and it's lovely to see how much, Georgia, that you respect the hard work that the NHS is doing. So congratulations on being STAR of the Week.
Congratulations on your respect, STAR. Year 5 staff STAR this week is somebody who made a very special appearance in our band last week. So it's for his wonderful guitar playing. It is for Mr. Campbell, and the STAR he's getting is creativity. Well done.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Hazel, and well done to all of the STARs and the learners in Year 5 this week. You've done a fantastic job. We're already looking forward to seeing what comes in for next week's assembly. The next announcement that we've got is for our Storyteller of the Week. And again, there's been lots and lots and lots of people sending in their entries. It's been very hard to choose. But the winner, who you're about to hear from a little tiny bit of their story, is the one and only Keely. So well done to you.
Sometimes perfectly nice parents have children who are monsters. Meet the Meek. This is Father Meek, Mr. Maurice Meek. As his name suggests, Mr. Meek is a mild-mannered man. He likes to wear socks with his sandals and would not dare to eat a peach in public. Mr. Meek works as a librarian. He loves libraries as they are quiet like him.
Brilliant stuff, Keely. Well done you. And we're looking forward to seeing what comes in next week for next week's Storyteller of the Week. We're going back now to Mrs. Hazel. She's been busy too. She's going to share a beautiful poem with us, and also to show that she can multitask, she's going to do some artwork at the same time. So enjoy this.
Congratulations to the STARs and learners this week. I'm now going to read you a poem by a lady called Gemma Peacock, and it's about the strange times that we're going through at the moment. I've read it to my children and they really enjoyed listening to it, and I hope that you enjoy listening to it too. The history books will talk of now, that time the world stood still, when every family stayed at home, waved out from windowsills, at those they loved but could not hold, because they loved them so. Yet whilst they did, they noticed all the flowers start to grow. The sun came out, they can recall, and windows rainbows filled. They kicked a football in their yards until the night drew in. They walked each day, but not too close, that time the world stood still, when people walked straight down the roads that once the cars did fill. They saw that people became ill, they knew the world was scared, but whilst the world stood still, they saw how much the whole world cared. They clapped on Thursdays from their doors, they cheered for the brave, for people who would risk their lives so others could be saved. The school closed down, they missed their friends, they missed their teachers so. Their mums and dads helped with their work, they helped their minds to grow. The parents used to worry that, as schools were put on hold, their children wouldn't have the tools they'd need as they grew old. But history books will talk of them, now adults fully grown, those little boys and girls back then, the ones who stayed at home. They'll tell you that they fixed this world of all they would fulfil. The rainbow children building dreams, they dreamed whilst time stood still.
Thank you very much indeed, Mrs. Hazel. Great stuff. Just before we go to the music, you might just want to pause the video, pause the assembly, and go and grab yourself something that you can make a bit of noise with. Something to bang, something to rattle, something to shake, and you can join in with the band. Mr. Joseph, it's over to you.
Each other and grow our hearts and minds.